my manager, Matt, he was like, can you just make something up-tempo for once?
No more 7-minute dirges about how sad
I'm so depressed. So I was like, fuck you, I'll write an upbeat song. And so that came out, and then he was like, hey, I think that's a banger.
You cover in the corner, can't find your father, let it
go. And I was like, no, it's not. And lo and behold.
That's why you have managers.
Yeah. It's like, I really had to swallow my pride.
I debated whether or not to start with this, but it just seemed like a fun place to start. You have a nickname that you have acquired. Captain Fiddlefingers?
Yes.
So tell me about, where did the nickname come from?
The nickname comes from my inability to stop playing an instrument. So I'll start with the thing that's probably right, and then I'll be like, no, give me another one. And it just gets more and more crazy. Once I feel like I'm like doing quite well in a take, I don't know why I'm doing this, but for now it's piano.
You're keyboard cat, yeah. I didn't realise.
Yeah. And I'll be really close to nailing a whole take, and then right at the end I'll just be like, and just do something really stupid, and then it's like, you were so close, just stay calm, come on, man.
So it's important to have somebody that will just go, no, Matt,
stop.
We're done.
Yeah, stop. We can make it better. I didn't know that I needed it until it happened, I think. Ever since I can remember, like ever since maybe when I was like 4 or 5, I would sit in my room and I had a little Walkman, and then I upgraded to a Discman.
Ooh.
That was a big day. And I would listen to records in my room, like from start to finish, and I'd just like rock back and forth to the rhythms, and I'd be breaking down the drums, and I'd be like, oh, because I would always be around music, and I went to church when I was young, and you know, I'd always be watching the drummer and the bass player and be like, oh, like, well, that works because they're doing things at the same time and he hits that there. Like my brain, like as a 7-year-old, is sort of doing that. And you cut to now where that part of my brain just goes bananas all the time. And I think I just need to figure out how to get that across, and what if I can break all those individual things down that create that feeling that I feel and hear in my head. Yeah, so let's do two.
Two rounds, yeah.
You mentioned you grew up in church, and one of the things you did long before anybody knew you was you signed up to this traveling touring band.
Very good, yes. And what I've done your research.
Well, actually, I went to school with a guy that was also in it as well.
Oh.
I mean, I'd have been a little bit after you, I think.
Yeah.
That's a big thing to do, right? It's a big thing to get up and move,
yes.
You know. What do you learn about yourself going on a thing like that?
That whole experience was pretty interesting. And I was 14 when I jumped on the road. My parents had a hard time letting me do that. The two people that ran it were a husband and wife couple, and they were Seventh-day Adventists. We lived in the garage of this house where the singers lived downstairs and the family lived upstairs. When we were home, we would be there, we'd just sort of do chores for them. They would pay us like $20 a show.
The economics of this stack up great.
I remember once my mum came to pick me up. I hadn't seen my parents for like 3 months. As a 14-year-old, that's a long time. Maybe 2 months, that could be embellishing. And the wife said to my mum, he can't go yet, he hasn't done his chores. And my mum was just like, I'm fucking taking my son, you fucking weirdos. Like, really upset at that point. And we were going into schools close to 8 or 9 shows a week, which is a lot. It made me tough, I think. I'm a sensitive person, but it made me like tough as a touring person. You have to basically have zero expectations. You have to sort of surrender to a schedule where you have kind of no free will. And then when I went to Idol, I was like, this is nothing. It's like we sing like 4 minutes a week.
And we cut the second verse and go straight to the key change.
That's right. Bring it in, Johnny. Like, and even I remember some of the camera crew coming up to me and just being like, you're a pro. Like, have you done things before this? I was like, yeah.
I lived in indentured servitude in that house. After your experiences with reality TV, one of the things you did was you went over to London. Is moving to London about giving yourself a clean start?
Yes, big time.
And did it work? Like, did you feel like you got a clean start out of that?
Yeah, I did actually. You know, I was playing open mic nights to like 4 people for months. I didn't know anyone. It's very hard to make friends over there, especially when you're like...
It's cold. It's cold. It's too cold to be friendly.
When I first got there, I was like walking down the street and I was like, here you go. Here you go. Like talking to people and people are like, holy shit, that guy is fucking weird. Because no one does that.
No, they don't.
People are a little bit like, don't talk to me. Don't look at me. Are you right? You're right, having a laugh.
I knew we'd get the voice out of him, actually, right?
We discussed this before the interview.
I've heard you describe the last album as, in some ways, it's a simple instructional album for Hugh, your son.
Yeah. It's more one of those things that when he's my age, he'll probably understand.
He's about one now, yeah?
Yeah. So
I felt like that context was important. Yeah. He's not sitting there like critiquing you.
Yeah. He's like, what did you actually mean by this, Dad? Like,
let's break this down for us.
Yeah. He's at the point where he gets a drumstick and goes, dad, 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 dad. Anything musical he associates with dad.
It tells me the branding is working.
Yeah.
At the very least, the branding is good.
I didn't even know that I was working on a record until I was told by my partner that she was pregnant. So I actually overheard a conversation that she was having with her sister, telling her that she was pregnant, and she didn't know that I was in the house. And I was like, I'm sorry, what? Like coming around the corner, and she was like, oh yeah, so this is cool. Like, I'm in shock.
Yeah, it is shocking, right? Yeah, like, not necessarily in good ways or bad ways, it's just like, it's a huge thing to conceptualize, right?
And like now in hindsight, I'm happy that everything happened the way it did, you know? And he's awesome. He's like, does not stop all day. Literally does not stop moving. He stopped for about 3 minutes today because I like was lying on the ground and he came and put himself on my back and then just came and gave me a kiss on the cheek and then was like, because I was like, ah, and he was like, oh.
I'll never miss you. Till I know I won't be coming home.
You've got a really active brain.
Somewhat, yeah.
What's the best way you know how to calm it?
I'm kind of really active, but at the same time, like, I go into this weird, like, it's like a bit of a zen state or something. Yeah. Like, I feel really comfortable making music, so I sort of lost a lot of my paranoia that I would carry around with me and a lot of my negative self shit that you project out onto the world.
That the world mostly isn't aware of.
No, not at all. But like you're living in fear that they're going to be aware of it at some point, you know. So that has subsided, you know, over time.
You can't let it destroy you. Don't regret the things that made you strong.
I think I'm like finally at a point where I can just kind of have fun. And I'm never really trying to have fun with music. I've always taken it really seriously. And that might have, again, stemmed from the whole idol thing. Yeah. Just being like, no, I would love to be taken seriously by people finally, because like I am pretty serious about this. Like
he says in that voice, which really helped the argument the time, I'm sure.
When you break, I break. When you crawl, I crawl.
All right, Mr. Fiddlefingers. Sorry, Captain Fiddlefingers.
Captain Fiddlefingers.
You earned that rank.
Goddamn. That's right, yeah. Don't call me First Mate Fiddlefingers. That sounds really weird.
Doesn't it?
Let's cut that then.